Thanks for that introduction, Leon. My name is Chelsea Catania, and I'm working with Professor Ariel First in the Department of Chemical Engineering. And I'm excited to share with you our project on keeping microbes alive. You might be wondering, why would we want to keep microbes alive? We were raised to think that all germs are bad. They're everywhere and they should be destroyed. But that's not the case. We're recognizing now that many bacteria are beneficial to our overall health and well-being. And many of them are actually pretty difficult to grow and keep alive, which is why we need to develop methods to keep the beneficial microbes or our probiotics alive and well. Consumer demand for probiotics is huge. The market is large and rapidly increasing. And while there are many products available, there aren't many bacteria species to choose from. Most probiotics on the market come from just four groups of bacteria, which also means their health benefits are limited. There's a huge opportunity right now in identifying other microbes that have new and even therapeutic benefits. This is obvious when we look at all the microbiome therapeutic companies that exist today and their valuations, in addition to all of the new startups that keep popping up across the world. Most, if not all, of these companies are focused on discovery. And although the future is promising, no new products are on the market yet. That's because these next generation probiotics are currently impossible to manufacture. Most of these target microbes are sensitive to oxygen, which means they need special handling, else they die in the process. Not to mention all of the mechanical, thermal, and chemical stresses that occur during manufacturing and in storage that affect the viabilities of all kinds of probiotics. We're developing a protective coating that can self-assemble on the surface of each cell while in solution. Unlike existing methods, this can be done on any type of cell and provide single cell protection from manufacturing stresses. It's real simple. We just add two components to solution for the coating to form, which also makes this method easy to scale up and deploy in existing manufacturing lines. You can think of our tech like a tiny suit of armor for bacteria that helps them make the stressful journey from the manufacturing floor to your gut and ready to fight for your health. Existing industrial processes generally follow this scheme. Bacteria are grown to a certain density and then concentrated. Growth media is replaced with a formulation specific for freeze drying, and then the dried product is put into pills. Our method can easily be integrated with the formulation step, enabling us to bring currently intractable microbes to market. One example of a currently intractable species that shows great promise for both humans and for animals is Faecalibacterium prausnitzii, or F. prau for short. High amounts of F. prau in the gut directly relates to overall health. However, these bugs are extremely oxygen sensitive and die within minutes when they're exposed to air. Extending the time this microbe can be handled would be monumental for its manufacturability. And this is just one example. Our method can protect all kinds of microbes from different stresses, not just oxygen. So far, with the help of the Deshpande Center, we've developed the coating process and demonstrated we can coat a handful of different bacteria species using no special equipment. We've monitored the viability of cells after the coating process and tried a few different chemistries to enable better cell growth. We also demonstrated that our material coating remains intact after freeze drying. Now that we've honed in on our technique, we're ready to test it out on F. prau. We'll be looking at how well our method protects this bug from air while it's in solution, after freeze drying, and after some time in storage. In summary, we're very excited about the future of microbiome therapeutics, and we want to enable this industry. Our goal is to produce a final product containing high levels of viable microbes. We focused on air tolerance because that's the biggest problem right now. But the material properties of our coating would enable our armored bacteria to withstand all sorts of stress. In the end, this method could be applied to a wide variety of microbial products across various industries. Last summer, during both the NSF iCorp program and other entrepreneurship programs, we conducted over 160 customer discovery interviews across many different industries, which led us to this hair on fire problem in microbiome therapeutics. But this technology is applicable to nutraceuticals, agriculture, and even cosmetics that employ microbes. With the Deshpande Center's support, we've been able to develop our method. Once our provisional patent is filed, we'll be able to search for development partners who have other microbes they want to bring to market, and we'll be seeking non-dilutive funding sources to continue our work. We're currently looking for microbiologists or industry members to collaborate with or team up with. If there's a microbe you want to protect, we'd love to talk to you further in the breakout room. And with that, I'd like to acknowledge our team, Professor Ariel and Dr. Gong Fan, and the Deshpande Center members for their advice and support. Thank you.